What's going on, dudes, boys and girls, friends and viewers, people who I do know and those I still do not. My name is Kolosalus. Welcome back to our beautiful but just how mysterious world of Subnautica. There's been some weird developments. I've been playing a lot of Stranded Deep lately, and I think there was an update, kind of like an unstable client update, but it still applied to the stable client. And basically what happened is I have stalkers right next to me. Oh, fuck. I have stalkers right next to me. And I also have some sand sharks somewhere. Like, there's a sand shark right there. Like, you guys know that two of these are, like, the most dangerous creatures in the actual world of Subnautica. So, I don't know what happened. I don't know why that happened. But now that apparently they spawn next to my base. And there's just nothing I can do about it. That's fine. We're gonna work with it, though. Today's goal... it's a little bit different than normal. Today's goal. Look at that. There's just some weird stuff going on, like some corals just floating and yeah. There's been some weird developments like that. The goal for today's video, though, is not going to be it's not going to be gathering a certain. Certain material is not going to be crafting anything. It's not going to be building base, unfortunately, yet. What is that? Salvage. Metal salvage. Can I scan it? I need to be careful with those sun sharks. Scattered wreckage. Right, so we... today... oh, crap. Today, we will be looking... for wreckages. Today we will be looking for places where I can scan certain stuff to actually gain blueprints for them. So we're looking for things like things like the sea moth, things like the charger for the batteries. We'll be looking for Seaglide and just different stuff like that. Very, very useful. Whoa, look at this little gale. Looks beautiful. I just wanted to go in there just because it was beautiful. Alright, so I did basically... I did prepare. So, as you see, I do have a little bit of water. And a lot of food, so we are set for at least a couple days. We don't have to go back home for those couple days. What I just have to be careful of is the big ass. Like, first of all, whoa there, Mr. Cow. Whoa there, I'm gonna sneeze. Right, so we have to be careful of the giants. There we are. I just heard a coral back. That is so. So satisfying. Look, we can actually see them from far. Like, they're not harmful to us, but just their sheer being here is just scary. Alright, so let's see. This is a wreckage, so let's see if there's anything here we can actually scan. Or anything we can actually pick up that is useful to us. That is so cool. Sounds so cool. Hopefully I won't get eaten by the Reaper Leviathan. I think that's what his name is. One of the scariest and most dangerous creatures in this game. We're actually very, very close to Aurora, so I would not be surprised if he was just like popped out of there like, yeah, what's up, dog? Is that me? Yeah, so let's see. Any stuff here? No, it's just metal salvage here. I don't see any... ooh, what's down there? I swear I heard something. Just metal salvage as well. Metal salvage. Oh, we can get oxygen from this. Look, those humbugs. No humbugs, but I'm not sure actually. Oh shit! Oh shit! Aurora's about to blow up. I'm actually very close to the explosion right now. A supercritical state in T-minus 10, 9, and I don't have a radiation suit yet. 6, 5, Yep, so that was the explosion of the Aurora. God, that was such a big explosion. So basically what happens now is I have to get the radiation suit. As long as I get it, I'm going to be safe. And I think I can get it from one of the lifeboats if I listen back to the messages from the communication center. Of my communication center. Right, so we went towards Aurora, but there was nothing there, really. So let's go this way. Let's go to the back of Aurora, see if there are any crash sites, so we can actually get the parts that we need. Salt. Nice. Look at this. This world is just beautiful. It's dangerous. Definitely dangerous. There's a lot of different monsters and just dangerous stuff out here. Okay, I see a crash site here. Okay, I see. We actually see a crash site, so let's dip down. See if we can scan anything that's going to be useful. Oh, what's this? Oh, nothing. I thought it's actually going to be something. That would have been cool. Is there really nothing here? So that's already two crash sites, and we just haven't seen anything which is useful to us. Oh, I see a crack there. Let's go this way. As in, like, maybe try to approach it from the back. Maybe there will be some crash sites up and over there. Just don't want to get wrecked by crocs. AKA stalkers. Let's go to the other side of this. Looks like we are actually approaching a different biome right now. I don't want to deep dive too much as well though, because I do not have the my I don't have the sea moth, I don't have the Seaglide, I cannot get out of like deep water very, very quickly, so. Can I actually just scan this? Radiation detected? Oh, so I cannot get close to the actual radiation, the actual Aurora. God damn it, that's a bummer. It's a bummer. I heard something. Is that a stalker? Hope not. There's something here. I'm not sure if it's just a box of stuff. What is it? Seaglide! So how many do we... I need one more part for that Seaglide. Oh, so it was actually inside of the box. The fragment of the Seaglide was actually inside of a box. Cow, please don't. Please don't do this to me. It's a metal salvage. Okay. Oh, it's dead. Okay. So we have to kind of make our way towards that. Oh, I see a crash site, okay. I think that's a guaranteed Seaglide for us right here. And that's what it is, boys. Empty box. I heard something. Something big, actually. I heard something big. Yeah, we are at the backside of Aurora right now. I can hear something big moving through the water. Hope it's not the Reaper or Leviathan just closing in on us right now. Okay. Oh no, it's just a volcano. Okay, I see. Dude, no one gives a fuck about the volcano. Let's get some copper. Chill, bruh! Can I, like, fix this or something? No, I can't. I thought for sure we can get Seaglide out of this. At least. At least. I think there still might be a way to enter this though. Like, there must be a way, right? Yeah, there is. Okay. Bioreactor fragment? We can actually fix that. That's a chair. Let's actually get a chair. I think we'll be able to build a chair inside of our base, so let's just get that for now. Is there anything else here? Bioreactor as well. Let's get out. We need some oxygen. And it's actually going nighttime now as well. And I still have to go through this scary forest.
Dehydration detected.
It's fine. Hydration's fine. Whoa, I don't see anything. I thought for sure I'll be able to at least see something still. That was weird. I don't know what it was. Desk. I'm pretty sure if I scan this, I will be able to then... Yeah, I can actually build it afterwards as well. Okay, I have a new blueprint, so let's try to repair this now. Okay, let's get out. I don't know what it was, because it's definitely not nighttime yet. And it's just suddenly gotten dark for some reason. I don't know what it was. I don't know, boys. What we can do is just have some water, actually.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Get some food as well into us. Okay, awesome. So, let's get in here. Mobile vehicle bay. Awesome. That's actually one of the vital things we actually need for our survival. Is there only one though? I think that was it. I think that was it, boys. Alright, so I guess it was kind of mid-success. This we have the bioreactor fragments, and we also got some chairs, some desks, so that's gonna be some you know, just some of the additional stuff towards our base. We did get one Seaglide, but it wasn't actually in that. It wasn't in that. What's the name? It wasn't in that actual... Whoa, that's just weird. Like, I'm swimming next to this forest and it just pops out right now. It wasn't in that crash site that we found it. We found it actually just randomly in the box somewhere. So we have to find one more of those Seaglide fragments. There might be just some stuff over here that I'm just missing. Maybe there's just a part of a Seaglide somewhere down. Oh, it's a bag. I can carry it. I don't know why do I need that for. What do I need that for? But the sun is setting. Okay. I need one more Seaglide. So that's another bag right there. Okay, I guess I can come back here in the morning. I think it's going to be much safer that way. Hopefully I'm not going to get attacked by the sand sharks. Oh, there's a sand shark right there, right below me. Or the stalkers right now. So let's just get home. There's a stalker right there. Alright, so that was a semi-successful day, at least to me. We got some of those parts, some of those blueprints. So let's check them out. So blueprints, mobile vehicle bay. We still need two parts and one more for the Seaglide. We already have blueprints for just, you know, just some basic stuff like the X compartment, T compartment. So those are basically the base building ones. I'm not sure where we're basically going to be located. We're going to be looking for the location in a different episode. But base attached air pump. There's just so much different stuff that I have to get. Rebreather, absorb CO2 to recycle used air at greater depths. Dive reel, anchors to a physical point. Chair, bioreactor, compost plant matter to energy, which is nice. I think that's going to be really, really important for us. We need 4x titanium. And then I think that that's actually for our base. And also we can actually build a desk and a chair right now, which is good. What we can do also right now, let's save up. And let's listen to those messages.
This is an automated bounce back from the Aurora mining vessel. Your distress signal has been received. An emergency relief team will be dispatched to your location. Estimated arrival time, 9:00
Well, that doesn't sound too good, did it? Is that the only message right now? Are there any more messages? Hello? Fuck. Okay, no more messages. How do we make water? Disinfected water. We need bleach. And for the bleach, we need common coral sample. I think I should have some of those. Yeah, plenty. Plenty. I prepared for it. I prepared. Actually, we have a new message. Before the episode, I actually went in just to get some water and some food for our actual, you know, for our endeavors. But again, semi-successful. I'm still happy with them. Still happy with them. So we have a couple of beaches. Therefore, we can make two drinkable waters. Disinfected water. Yeah, like salt and the coral, like the common coral sample are just very, very easy to get anyway. So I don't really mind spending them. I'm gonna drink that. This is Lafette in Lifeboat 17. I survived impact, but there's something outside the hatch and it's trying to get in. If anyone's still out there, my coordinates are attached. This message will now repeat. Okay, and actually it shows us Lifeboat 17 is 560 meters that way. It's actually 100% away from the Aurora. So, and I think right next to all of these lifeboats, there's actually like crash sites next to them, so. Chill, look, hi friend. Damn, he's so aggressive with those balls. Get your ass out of here. Get your big glowy balls out of here. Alright, I'll just see you guys in the morning. Good morning, everybody. Let's continue our search for the Seaglide, for all the fragments. I really want to get these before I move on with my game. So maybe let's start making our way towards this this lifeboat a little bit. Which way did I go yesterday that I found that big crash site? I think it was this way. So let's actually make our way to this way first. Let's actually see if there's anything in that crash site. Anything that's worth our attention. We're going to get those salt deposits. They're going to be really very, very important for our survival. And let's see if we can actually find the final Seaglide piece and some more pieces of just different things that we need. So far we aren't successful.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Was that a sun shark? No. Okay, so let's get out, get some oxygen. Seaglide is going to be so, so important for our, not survival, but just overall success in this world, just because it would just allow us to get around faster, get around everything faster. I don't know what those luggage bags are for, but I guess they're here. Lab counter, we can actually scan that for additional blueprint. That actually takes a long time to scan. Awesome, a new blueprint. Okay, but I don't see any Seaglide fragments, which sucks. Which honestly sucks. Honestly, if we go deeper, I don't see anything that interesting either. So I'm actually wondering if we should actually go down there. Maybe something fell down. Maybe something fell down from this cliff. So let's just try to see. Maybe there is something right below. All right. So where do we go from here? Because like to actually go deeper, I need the Seaglide. I need the sea moth. So where do we go from here? How do I find the final piece of the puzzle? The final piece that we actually need to create the Seaglide, to start creating a lot. Here is another one of those forests where stalkers hang out. Not really up for that. Not really up for visiting. So right now, I'm actually getting away from Aurora. I'm actually wondering if there will be any kind of crash sites or any scannable items here. I see a box and there's something in it, and it might be the Seaglide! Yes! So we actually have a blueprint now for... Cow, please get away from me. Blueprints. Seaglide. I need copper wire, titanium, lubricant, and battery. So let's go to our base and let's build ourselves a Seaglide. And you guys will see just how much faster we can get to places. And actually, we will have to craft some of those batteries as well. So let's just grab some of those mushrooms as a backup. And they're going to be really, really important. Metal salvage, not really important. Metal. Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining. 10 seconds on the oxygen. Dude, clutch. Clutch. Losing track of my oxygen levels, then going and then getting up. Clutch in there. Hi, Blotherfish. Alright, there's a sun shard right next to my base, which is never a good sign. Dude, he's so fast as well. My god, there's a stalker there as well. God damn it, guys. Like, why are you cracking? Why are you cracking my base? I don't like it. These guys, like weren't there before, and they're just gonna move. They're like, yep, we're just gonna move our neighborhood next to your place. Okay, so what do we need? I know we need a lubricant. What do I need for the lubricant? I need creepvine cluster. Well, god damn it. I also need some more batteries. I need batteries. I need the copper wire as well. Advanced materials. No, this thing is going to be here. Titanium, fiber mesh, silicone rubber. Electronics, copper wire. I need copper ore times 2. I definitely have a lot more in here. Where's the copper? The copper, so electronics, copper wire, there we go. We will also need copper for the battery, which is okay, but we already have that. Deployables, beacon, okay, waterproof locker. So there's a Seaglide. So we already have copper wire and we have titanium. We do need a battery. So let's grab ourselves some more copper. Excuse me. There's the battery. That's weird. It looks weird, but okay. And now we only need the lubricant. So All right, Crocs. I have to get your, I have to get some of your creep vines, dog. The easiest way to get those creep vines was actually to, like, towards Aurora, like, right there, I think. Where's Aurora? Yeah, she's right there. So I think the easiest way to get them is to get them there, like, in that little passage where there are not a lot of Crocs just gonna floating around, like, in this passage right here. Oh god, lag. Okay, I see a croc right next to a creep vine. Cluster. Oh yeah, he's scouting it. He knows I want it. He knows I want that creep vine. There was a croc right there. Okay. There's a croc right there. My god, what is with all the crocs today? What is up with all the crocs today, boys and girls? Oh, might be sneaky about it. Might be sneaky about it. I'm just not. What was that? God damn it. Something's eating me. Something's hitting me. I don't know what it is. Get away from me. Holy shit, it just drained so much life from me. That was horse shit. I didn't even know how to fight it. I got surprise fucked. And there's a stalker right in the way over to my house. I think there's a med kit right there, which I can actually use in my house itself, so. No. No sharks. Please no sharks. God. Well, so that was an unsuccessful run. Alright, let's try to use a mech kit. Alright, 66 health, that's fine. We have to get those creep vines though. Like, I'm not giving up. I have to get them. I have to get them in order to actually get the Seaglide. And once we get the Seaglide, it's going to be much easier to do anything. Okay, let's see here. I don't see any creep vines clusters for now. I see them right there. And I don't see any... Oh, there's a fucking stalker. What the hell is that? I'm just so afraid now of any kind of... any kind of life form. Step down. Yeah, this stalker is right next to my face. Okay, let's try to get a little bit more in. If it keeps lagging like that, I'm gonna get so wrecked. Okay, let's go for it. Inventory full. Okay, let's go. I think it's Gucci. I think we're Gucci. I think we actually make the Seaglide now. I think No Stalker saw us, and we are making our way back home to make the Seaglide. Oh, Seaglide is going to make it so much easier to do everything. So much easier, I'm telling you guys. You guys will see. You guys will see in a second just how much better and how much easier everything gets. Don't shoot your balls at me. All right, okay. So now we have those vine clusters. We can make the lubricant. And now that we have the lubricant, we can actually make the Seaglide. Okay, picked up. Oh, God. You can see it right there. Hi. Hi, fish. Let's actually build water over. Thank you. Oh, there's a new message. Awesome. So let's drink some water. Let's eat our cured pepperfish. And so we have the Seaglide right there. We have some metal salvage, which I don't actually need now. But there's no way I can drop it anywhere. So we have fiber mesh. We have quartz. We have a lot of this. Let's pick up the copper, and let's make some batteries, I think. Let's make some batteries. Electronics, battery. I have any more mushrooms, really? I didn't pick up as many as I thought. I thought I picked up a lot of mushrooms. Just saying. There's mushrooms in there right below me, so I'll be able to get some. Alright, awesome. You have the mushrooms. Let's make like two more batteries or something. Batteries like will be able to just get you power on the go. So I'll be able to just exchange batteries. But what do I need the power for? I need it for the Seaglide. And by the way, this is Seaglide. Look how fast we're going right at this moment. We can get to so many places and we can go deeper because I can get out quicker out of certain areas. So you can see we are so quick now. And then like whenever I need to, I just use this to get out. But you can see how much actually power it drains. You can use the R to change batteries as well, you see. I can actually use different batteries. And then in one of the next episodes, we're gonna also be trying, we'll be trying to get we'll be trying to get the charger for the batteries inside of our base, so we'll be actually able to charge the batteries themselves. There's a self-charging power cell, power 25. So I actually do have to get this somehow. I don't know how do I do it though. I want to drop off some of those metal salvages that I don't actually need. My storage compartment. Drop that off. But there's still a lot of like this creep vine clusters. I have a lot of salt in me, by the way. I'm a salty person. Let's actually let's switch these. I'm gonna throw these out. I don't think I need the fire extinguisher, but just in case, we're gonna keep it. Other than that, I think we have everything. So let's just drop some of those. I can't actually drop them off. So what do I do with those creep vine clusters? Do I just throw them out? I'm not gonna throw them out. They're actually very important, aren't they? Where are those things that I don't need? I don't need this. There we go. I don't need this and this. I do need the creep vines. I'm just gonna keep them for now. But yeah, so that'll be it for today, guys. Thank you guys for so much for watching. We did get what we came for. We did get the Seaglide. And we already saw in action how fast it allows us to go. But next episode, we're going to be looking for some more fragments for just different, again, just different blueprints. Because we want to start building our base. And in order to start building our base, we actually will need the base builder or whatever you want to call it. But anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. Stay tuned for the next one. It's going to be much better because we actually have a Seaglide now. And I'll see you guys then.